Good Friday morning, everybody. After a kind of raucous night across the Mid-South with showers and thunderstorms and very breezy conditions as our latest tropical depression, what's left of Laura, makes its way on through the area, things are a little calmer this morning, but not by much. We'll take a look out into the farther reaches of the Atlantic and see what's going on out that direction and what might be heading our way, and a quick check of your forecast into the weekend as well. What's left of Laura is rotating through the area. You can clearly see the storm system making its way on through. The center of rotation is up around the Missouri, Kentucky, Arkansas area. You can see everything kind of rotating its way around that, and a lot of moisture making its way on through the area, helping to feed these showers and also these thunderstorms for this morning. We've actually had time right now being about 6:51 that we're recording this, that red rectangle that you see there, the polygon, that's a tornado warning, as a tornado has just passed very close to the Oxford, Mississippi area, making its way up toward Faulkner, Mississippi for this morning. We're not seeing a lot of great signatures with this, but according to the National Weather Service, there is the possibility of some areas of rotation forming in here. Matter of fact, you can see a little bit of that going on right into there. A bit of a couplet taking place here. And again, that's going to be making its way up into around the rest of this tornado warning. That'll be expiring here relatively soon. That is in effect until, 6:37 a.m. for portions of the area. So that'll be that should have expired by now at this point, but again, we're looking at this system, okay, issued at 6:37 until 7:15. So we may see even more storms like this throughout the rest of the day, so please keep that in mind. Be weather aware today. Make certain you know where your safe place is. Make certain you know exactly how to get there in as soon amount of time as possible. Most, again, of what we're looking for at this point back to our east and south, most of this is just rainfall, but we could see the irritation of the atmosphere stir up some more showers and thunderstorms, and that could be a bit of a problem out there for today, especially for anybody traveling through this. Very windy, wind advisory in effect, and more potential, again, of rain and thunderstorms out there. Here's what it looks like, again, on the ground. We've got, again, the possibility of some more thunderstorms out there from this system that is now making its way through the Midwest and portions of the Missouri, Arkansas, Boot Heel area, crossing the Mississippi River. This is the scan from overnight and showing, again, the storm making its way on through. Now, because it is a tropical depression, just dwindling into that, the National Hurricane Center is no longer tracking it, but the latest forecast for this storm has it heading overland across the Appalachians, right over Chesapeake Bay, and out into the ocean. And if you take a look into around that area where you see the letters turn from D to S again, D is depression. S means by the time it hits the Gulf of Maine, we could be seeing another storm forming if conditions are right. This time it'll be an extra tropical depression and storm heading up and away from us, meaning it's forming outside of the tropics, so it should not be too much of a problem for anybody else except for around Newfoundland. St. John's could be looking at some windy conditions out there, and then after early next week should be up in the North Atlantic, and with that colder water should not be that much of a problem. The orange colors, that's the higher amount of moisture, and again, seeing the storm system rotation draw that moisture upward, that's the fuel for the thunderstorms. And there's a little bit more of that coming in from out west. It's not much, but we are seeing again a little bit more activity from that going on. So we could be looking again at some more chances of showers and thunderstorms heading on through. The actual area of low pressure just to the north of Little Rock, and again showing up at some very breezy conditions out there as those winds whirl around into the Mid-South area, seeing those winds continue throughout the rest of the day. Here in the Mid-South, again, we still have the possibility of severe weather, slight risk category in the yellow shaded area. Green indicates the darker green is a marginal risk, less of a threat, but still possible. And the lighter green colors right over here on the edge of the screen, showing again the lesser amounts of just general thunderstorms. So everybody has a possibility of thunderstorms today, but some of those could be strong to severe. We also have a flash flood watch in effect for all of the Mid-South area at this time. And as we go throughout the rest of the day, We also have a wind advisory for winds of 15 to 25 miles per hour and some wind gusts of around 35 miles per hour. So choppy traveling across much of the Mid-South today. Please keep that in mind if you're going to be heading out the door relatively soon. Rest of the forecast, showers and thunderstorms today. Possibility of another inch or two of rainfall for much of the area. We'll clear out tomorrow. Lots of sunshine back into the mid-90s. Heat indexes tomorrow with enough sunshine could mean a heat advisory for the Mid-South, which is about 105 plus, so very steamy on Saturday. Beginning Sunday, we'll be looking at the possibility of more showers and thunderstorms going all the way into around next Wednesday and continuing again through next Wednesday, but then dropping off by just a little bit on the warm side, a lot of sunshine heading into the first full weekend of September, but not seeing much of any other problems. Again, more chances of rainfall in the next few days could be an issue for outdoor activities. Taking a quick look out into the tropics, not just one, but two storm systems out there to be aware of. One has just left the coast of Africa, giving that one a 30% chance of developing into something in the next few days, according to the National Hurricane Center, and also a 30% chance from a storm system in mid-Atlantic, just to the west of the Leeward Islands, and also just northeast of South America. That one will, both of those need to be watched as we go into the next couple of days. So we see again the potential for more storm systems out there. Remember, we're not even at the peak of hurricane season. That happens September the 10th. So we've got a ways to go. And just because Laura has made its way through doesn't mean we're not going to get any others into the Mid-South or the East Coast or the Gulf Coast or anything else. So now is the time to be very weather aware as we watch these storm systems make their way into and through the Atlantic Basin. So stay tuned for more on that. As of right now, it doesn't really look like much. And notice again, right in the middle of the screen, that sort of dusty brown color, that's dust off the Sahara. So that might do a pretty good job of helping to reduce the possibility of any thunderstorms or any tropical systems getting formed out there, but they have formed in similar conducive environments. So once again, we could be looking at some more trouble in about a week's time, depending on how these things go. We'll be watching them very carefully, so stay tuned for more on my social media websites, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and a whole bunch of others out there. So find me out there someplace, and we'll keep you advised on that. And of course, throughout the rest of the day today, looking at the potential for more severe weather, tornadoes possible. And again, this is something to watch out for, not to mention those breezy winds and wet roadways are not going to make good combinations. So please be cautious out there throughout the rest of the day. Thanks a lot for watching Weather from Oz. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. We'll continue to monitor the forecast through the weekend, updating you on social media. Stay safe out there and stay aware that weather can change. So it's a good opportunity to make sure that you're paying attention to things to stay safe. And we'll help you do that right here. Thanks for joining us and hope everybody has a great and safe weekend.